I believe.
And speaking of which, we do have both our runners here in the Discord. Once again, GG's guys, putting the race to the limit for the full three games. But right now, it's Casual Tom that winds up being the victor over you, RSPC 2-1. How y'all guys feel about y'all race?
That was intense. Oh my god, so many mistakes in that second one. I couldn't get the bubble zip. I gave up on the crash zip too soon. I had a feeling there'd be shrimp later. I thought maybe if I tried enough times, I'd get some luck, but anyway.
Don't worry, I made up for it in the third game.
I mean, that must have been a really good second game. So, yeah, GG's for that. Really keeping me on my toes.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. I had a lot of fun tonight. Absolutely. I hope everybody was watching did, too. I gotta tell you, my brain was still in burst chaser mode for game three in terms of what I needed, because I wasn't thinking about like items and stuff in game two. But I'm like, yeah, I got item two and item three. I could go into Crash Man, that's fine. And I'm like, wait, no, I need item one for this just in case. And yeah, I totally whoop fell apart.
So yeah, right, I think I want to talk about the which one was yeah about Casual Tom, the second race. I want you to talk about that that Crash Man. Well, both y'all had different issues with Crash. You had issues with Crash in the third race, RE, but for you, Casual Tom, that was a pretty costly Crash. Can you go through what was going through your mind, especially since you kind of missed that first zip and wound up going through, tried to do the platforms normally?
Yeah, you know, recently in practice, I found myself in a situation where screen one had fat fans, and I had softlocked myself, and luckily it was the first stage I picked, like just trying to do the Buster Only Crash zip. So when I didn't get that zip the first time, like I was pretty convinced I did it right, but you know, sometimes I just, maybe my A trigger is off a bit, like maybe a couple frames or whatever. So I was like, alright, well, maybe the shrimp is causing me a problem, let me just whatever, I mean, I got item one, let me just go for it. And as I was climbing, I was like, wait a minute, those were shrimp on the first screen. Well, maybe I can, like, damage boost and not fall off if I climb high enough. Or maybe I'll get lucky and they'll spawn high enough and let me through. And at some point, I was just like, yeah, you know what? Just, I've taken enough damage, go back to the first screen, and then sure enough, I got the zip. But then later on, it occurred to me, I didn't get that bubble zip either, because there was that shot man on that screen with that shot. I knew I wasn't going to make it across in time. So, that ended up really costing me. But other than that, I felt pretty good about how I did for the most part, minus, I think there was a costly death in Wily 4 in like maybe the first race or something, but yeah, that's pretty much all I gotta say, really. You know, lesson learned, I guess. Just don't give up on that zip so quickly next time.
What happens with you in Metroids, man? What's up with all the Metroid deaths? Why do you hate Metroid? Do you love Metroid so much, or do you hate them? Like Creed has his grabs, you know? Well, is Metroids your bane?
You know, I just When I don't see my beloved dollar store Metroids from the vanilla game, I just want to headbutt them. I'm like, get out of here. Get out of the screen. But instead of shooting them, I headbutt them, and then I fall into, you know, holes.
What do you think about that? What do you think about that air stage in that last seed?
Tom, you're the only guy that I see that died to air so much, man.
Oh, man.
Seriously? Man. I never seen a guy that dies two times in air all the time. Like, every race. Like,
the enemies...
I think this was fine. Ari did it three times fine, I believe.
Wow.
He was taking it slower, though.
There was a lot of Buster Mune enemies there.
Yeah, on that last seed, the enemy set was crap, but I ended up getting item 2 out of stage 1. I went straight into it stage 2, and I was able to get through with no problems. Wow. Just had to take it a little slow.
Yeah, the make or break on the last stage, guys, was because Ari went to Crash Man without item 1. That was the difference, and yeah, he had to do the elevator screens. He didn't do the zip, and the elevator screens were really, really slow. While Tom did the zip, like one B trigger, and here we go, and we skipped everything. While Ari had to climb everything.
I got stuck in the elevator screens for like 3 minutes.
Yeah, that was the only thing, actually. That was the only mistake, I think. Ari, later on, Ari died a lot, but that was due... I know why he died a lot, because he wanted to be faster. But that happens. It happens.
Mm-hmm.
What do you feel, Ari? How do you like these races? Like, what do you think about your races? I think you did a great job, honestly. Like I said, your previous two races, man, you're an inspiration for me this time around, man, because you pulled a lot these years. Like, you pushed a lot, you learned a lot of new strats, you know.
Well, I can tell you.
What happened?
Well, tonight specifically, I had a lot of fun. Like, you know, there was some, you know, things that caused me to be in this race that were probably already spoken about. So I'm like, you know, throw caution to the wind. Let's try to learn some Burst Chaser. Let's do Buster Only. Make it fun for everybody watching. And, you know, if we took it to game 3, just try to play my best. And that's kind of what happened. And, well, you know, the rest was history. So GG's to Casual Tom. But I think I've spoken about this before in previous races that, you know, if I'm going to contend in this, like, I really want to contend. I have to push my limits, do things that I'm not comfortable with, learn things, because things are going to come across that I'm just not going to be able to progress past certain runners if I don't. So,
yeah, man, I really appreciate you for saying that. Like, pushing yourself is something with speedrunning. Fun or not, you just want to push yourself. And you're not done yet, by the way. Don't give up. You're not done yet. You're in the lower bracket, but you're very far ahead in the lower bracket. So it doesn't take much for you to come back, you know?
Oh, yeah. You know, I'm just going to get back in the lab, you know, practice a lot more, clean up these little errors I've been making in the regular runs, and just, you know, see what I can do.
Yep, nice. And meanwhile, for a casual Tom, you're pretty much just sitting pretty in the winner's finals, pretty yet again, just getting yourself pretty deep into the tournament, but this time in the upper bracket, just waiting for your next opponent to come up. We still waiting for one first round match to get up so we can get to that point so you can face your inevitable opponent, but right now you're sitting pretty, probably at the best position at the moment.
Yeah, feels pretty good. You know, I might have a little break here for like a week or two while I'm waiting for things to play out. Just, yeah, remind me to practice those seeds.
Yeah, you can remind me, man. Just watching somebody's stream, I gotta watch Tom or somebody to remind myself to do something, because, yeah, I'm waiting for the same, well, I'm on the same ball as Tom, yeah. Waiting for these matches to finish. So we're both waiting, and we're both not, at least I'm not playing a lot. And that is gonna be, that's gonna be causing issues, so I don't really know if I'm gonna be joining Tom, really. I haven't played since my last match, and Tom is kind of fresh.
For now, I mean, we'll see how long that lasts. I get distracted pretty easily, as you know, so let's be honest. Yeah. Well, yeah, just, I gotta give myself a little bit of motivation, write myself a sticky note, put it on the monitor.
Yeah, one seed today keeps the doctor away. Let's go.
Mm-hmm, good advice.
No, I'm not. Don't. Don't do it. Don't do this to yourself. But yeah, this is a really fun game. If somebody wants to play this, like, choose your settings and play with the game. I highly advise so. Creed already explained, if you want to join, we don't enforce skill levels here. Everybody can join, new or not. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, you'll probably like it. You can join the Discord and play for fun. Nobody will deny you a race, probably.
More the merrier. For real.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and despite the hiccups and despite the fact that I have to pack up to the lower bracket, I had a blast today. This was so much fun.
Dude, this is the first time I told Creed, I see you do good with. Really? Like, really? Yikes. He really pushed a lot, Tom. Like, I told you, man, this year is going to be like the first year probably where everybody pushed a lot. This guy knows his stuff already. He's prepared, man. I'm not going to be surprised if he knocks a few faces off soon enough. He did good wood. He did zips that I didn't expect, man. Really.
No. Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
All right, as we come to the close of this particular race, I want to let everyone know that we do have one more match that has been scheduled, and it's our final first round race. Had a little bit of delays. It's, you know, our RL stuff, that stuff happens, but we're about to get that race coming up, and that's coming up tomorrow at 9 p.m. Eastern Daylight between Krebel Star and Matt Philly. So, of course, keep your eyes on the Speed Gaming Network of channels to see where we're going to get that. But other than that, once we have that, we're probably going to have the gates wide open, because that's pretty much the only game that we really need to push the tournament onward. So hopefully we get that done and we can get this tournament back up to speed. But right now, this is pretty much it. So, once again, you know what we got to do. We got our shout-out. So, shout-out to Duckfish, the creator of the randomizer, our community devs, Matt Ewalker, Squidman, and Daggett, for continuing where Duckfish left off when he gave the reins to creation of the randomizer to us. Also to our tournament organizer, Charlie Boy, who also manned the addition of sprites, the new addition of the music party, you had a very large part in handling with that music. Also, we, once again, we already did our shout out to Speed Gaming. Thank you for allowing us to host this tournament one more time. And speaking of Prodigy, thank you for co-commentating with me.
Yeah, thanks, Creed, for doing absolutely everything tonight. I'm quoting everything because it's everything, and making me feel at super comfortable. Like I didn't even need to move my finger, which is probably bad, but you know, Creed is Creed. Creed did everything tonight for you guys to feel great. Thanks for him to commentating. Thanks to Speed Gaming and all the other things that he mentioned earlier. And most probably, I'm gonna thank Ari and Casual Tom for showing up for racing.
Last but not least,
yeah, they are the most important people, and they're the stars tonight for you guys. I hope you like the races, and that's all from me.
Just like to second what Prodigy said about co-commentary with LV Creed. Bladed thanks for the other night. That was a lot of fun, and yeah, completely agree. Made me feel comfortable. Didn't have to lift a finger. Took care of all the work. Made a lot of fun. So. Much appreciated for that, and to you, Prodigy, as well, and but Creed, did you do tracking tonight, or was that...
Yeah, Creed did everything.
Oh, wow, yeah, so thanks so much for that, and thanks, RSPC, for a really great three rounds, my goodness.
Yeah, thank you, too, Tom. Congratulations again. Good luck in the finals. Had a lot of fun tonight, and I hope everybody watching did, too.
And with that, for everyone here, this is your boy, LV Creed. Keep your eyes on Speed Gaming for the next races. And until then, wish you all a very good morning, evening, afternoon, wherever you may be. Catch you later, everyone.
Have a fantastic day.
Thanks. Have a good one.